All right, we are watching Game 2, Delta Esports versus Rise Again, the AVGL College League. My name is Billy. I am the support for Delta Esports, and I wanted to go back over this game. So first of all, picks and bans coming out here. We have second pick. They started off banning Fafnir. We answered with Rat. They answered with Scylla for some reason, and then we answered with Al. Basically, their jungler has an amazing Ratatosk and an amazing Yao Kuang, so he doesn't get to play those gods. Their mid laner also is lent on Scylla, so the Scylla ban was actually very favorable for us. They're going to first pick Thor, and we are going to. He had a decent game on Thor last time, but it wasn't anything standout, so we're not too afraid of the Thor. Doesn't have the same pressure that Ratatosker brings, the same safety that Ratatosker brings. We're looking at Kronos first pick, which is a weird first pick. But we're really looking for the dual lane to perform very well in this game. That's kind of our focus. We want to get our side lanes ahead. Kronos Gwan. The Gwan gets the Kronos through the early game. Healing's very strong right now, so that's also a priority. And the Kronos not only gets a free laning phase, but also puts Coco in a position to carry, which is what we want. They pick up Ryjen, they pick up Odin. Game one, the Odin had a pretty good performance, so the Odin makes perfect sense for him. And it does make sense against the Guan Yu as well, but I can always just pick up Phantom, so not a huge issue. The Ryjen does bring a lot of mid pressure, but we're trying to think of a way to counter that here. Last pick in the first picking phase before the second bans come out. And we're probably looking at jungle here. And there's an Erlong Shen. Ajax really doesn't play very much Erlong. He's never played the god before. But, I mean, I pretty much gave him a quick rundown. Yeah, push two, win the game. There you go. So we're really looking for the Erlong to cripple, you know? That's Erlong's go-to. And right now they have three characters that have movement abilities. You've got Thor Hammer, you've got Odin Jump, you've got Ryjen Leap, Dash, Teleport, Thingamajig. If we can shut down the Ryjen ability, we can blow up Ryjen. If we can shut down the Odin ability, they don't have an engage. If we can shut down the Thor ability, he doesn't have an escape, and we can kill him. So that's our thought process there. Their Hunter has only played Apollo and Rom. Didn't have great games on either of them, but they're obviously comfort picks, so we're gonna ban away. I'm not sure what they banned here. Pretty sure it didn't matter. Yeah, they banned Giannis, which is a pretty good ban from them. We ban Rom. And I'm assuming they banned another mid. They banned Toon Bots, so they don't think the Erlong is jungle, which is a mistake. So, we Gucci. We Gucci, yo. We Gucci. So, Mexican for the win. And our next pick here, I think we're going to pick up our solo laner. Empyrean was really touting the tier, so we were like, sure, take it, you know? He had a tough game. The first game he played Vamana against an Odin. Rough matchup. Vamana kind of has to stand in the wave to use his Umbrella Rang, and then Odin can just jump on him for free. and you can't clear with just Armored Umbrella. Tyr has the ability to Fearless through the wave so that Odin can't hit him and the wave. So Odin has to choose between poking and clearing the wave. Tyr has a better matchup against Odin than a Vamana does. Just also because Vamana can't get out of the ring and basically his ultimate's completely useless while in the ring. Tough choice for Vamana. He's gonna pick Ul. I actually do like the Ul here. I think that's a really good pick because you do need more CC. You know, you've got Raijin Taunt, you've got Thor Hammer or Thor Hammer, Thor Wall and Thor Ult, but having an extra stun that can be really important. And you're up against either a Guan Yu or an Erlang Xin in lane, so you're gonna need some extra push. They do switch over to Terra Jing Wei though. The Terra obviously is an excellent pick. The support isn't the greatest player in the world, and their Hunter isn't the greatest player in the world, so we're perfectly happy giving them high priority picks. Let's go ahead and go to the match here. Lumicide does have a pretty good Thor, so we're trying to shut that down in this game. Everybody's gonna load in. My camera's stuck. Move my camera. Thanks. All right, looks like we're going to be spectating the entire game. Well, their support went Watchers this game, which is one step up from their last game, so that's good at least. But we put down two wards here and here. We didn't think they would invade, but we just wanna have vision on that area. We know that they like to pressure this side of the map early, so we're just trying to counter that the best we can, get some early wards out so we at least know where they are. Okay, Terra got her wall first, which explains why their clear was so slow. As Terra, you don't want to get your wall first. You want to get your dash first or your three first. Yeah, we did triple camp, and we clear now. They beat us to lane, they did double camp, and we get to lane at almost the same time. Coco is gonna chill in lane here. Let's watch Coco for a bit. I'm not gonna try to talk too much about macro tactics because I don't want to give too much away. There's still a small chance that we have of making the championships. Coco had a nice ability there. Terra kind of walked behind the wave into the Kronos, which was nice of her. He's gonna get stunned out. I'm actually really lucky. Terra's been saving all of her stuns for Kronos and letting me just like Talu assault her whenever I want to. Talu assault the wave. If you can stun out Guan Yu's clear, Guan Yu becomes a bot. There's nothing you can do. We're just trying to out-clear them right now because there's no way we should be out-clearing this lane. Jingwei Terra has much better clear than Guan Yu because Terra can completely shut down Guan Yu's clear just by stunning it. Let's go ahead and pop over to mid lane. Check out my man Mace Dingle. Just gonna clear out some backs. And we first blooded them in duo. I forgot about that. I'm no longer in that lane, so we don't know what happened. And my camera's broke, so I can't roam. I literally have free cam. There we go. Buggy piece of crap. Let's go over and check out this solo lane matchup. Looks like Tier's under tower, or pushing him under tower, and we still have control over the fires, which is one thing that this team has really prospered about, just like completely taking control of the fire camps. And Ajax is gonna gank solo. If he jumps, boom, he should die now. Like, oh, feels bad, man. Knock up, and he's still dead. Now you gotta get out, guys. Course in the sky. Raiden jumped in on Tier. Yeah. That's a Tier, buddy. And, well, mostly more than him being a Tier, neither of these guys have backed. Right? So they're sitting up there with very, very little power behind their punch. And even though they hit Thoril, Raijin didn't ult immediately. If Raijin would have ulted immediately, then there was a good chance that they were able to at least poke him out heavily so he couldn't farm the next wave. But he didn't full commit. Like, they weren't thinking. I went ahead and ulted this Thor in mid here. We have a chance to kill him. Probably could have killed him if he hit the pin, but Ajax would have died, so I'm kind of glad he didn't hit the pin. That's a Odin ult. I don't have Ghostwalk yet, so I went Curse for the Terra. So he dies. There's nothing really we can do about that. They should be doing that a lot more than they are. And, more importantly, is the 0-0-0 slash line on our Kukulkan at 4 minutes into the game against Thor Odin. I realize the Odin is solo, but still. That Thor should be destroying Kukulkan. They got the mid camps there. They're rotating two people over to Fire Creeps, which we expected. What we didn't expect was Terra to be in that lane. And while Terra is sitting in solo, I'm farming. Already, actually, I have a 300 gold lead on Terra. Full boots over her. Not looking too hot for my friend Strikes 1090. Got some XP from that wave. We're just trying to group. We're trying to get gold right now. That was my call here. Let's try and group in gold. Because we have vision on it. They're going to gank this duo lane. I'm not needed over there because, regardless of whether I'm there or not, it's a pin into an airstrike, guaranteed every time. Or it's a pin into Jingwei's death if Jingwei chooses not to airstrike. The other option would be Jingwei beads, but, oh, somebody started Aegis. Why'd you start Aegis? Oh yeah, pin into Kukulkan ult. Erlong's broken, dude. Erlong is broken. Thor is in solo, because why not? You know, it's not like Thor has anything else to farm, you know. No back camps or anything. He gets out with the barest amount of HP, thanks to the Terra ult. Whatever. We force two ultimates for some regular abilities. I'm down. Fires are spawning soon. We know that because we still have the timer on them, even though we didn't get them on the last spawn. And speed buffs are spawning, which we could look to invade. So we're looking to fight here. I ult in. We get Rigel, Thorhammer. Ajax Hog Speed. We get a 1-for-1 trade. We kill Rigel for me, which is definitely worthwhile. And then Kukla Khan shows up a little bit late and a dollar short. It should be okay. That is the power of Erlong right there, ladies and gentlemen. That is Erlong 10 into Kukulkan ult. There's nothing that man can do unless he has Aegis. And speaking of Aegis, let's take a quick peek over at duo lane, where Kronos is defeating Jing Wei by 600 gold. Somehow. I've amassed another 200 gold on the Terra, and another level, so we're looking just fine in that instance. Kukulkan Khan actually somehow has a lead on a Raijin. Kukulkan Khan Erlong lead on Raijin Thor. Nobody should have a lead on Raijin Thor. The most you should do is go even with them. But that's what's happening. So we're down. Raijin's gonna get poked. Raijin decides to jump in. We just tornado him for free, and he dies. That's why you don't jump in unless you're gonna kill somebody, because that is a free death every time, guaranteed. More farming. Their blue buff is up for some reason. We didn't know that, or we would have been over there like flies on honey. This time the Tyr is definitely beating the Odin in lane. This is the point where neither of them are really going to kill each other. Actually, Tyr could kill Odin because he went round shield, not silver breastplate. So it's a little mismatch there. But all in all, Tyr really shouldn't kill Odin. Odin shouldn't really kill Tyr. This is a farm test now. Let's leave that lane. Heading back over to mid here. I've got 2 levels on Terra. Ajax has 2 levels on Thor. And Mace has a level on Kenyan. We're feeling pretty good. Over in the duo lane, Coco is even with CJM in levels, but is actually 600, almost 700 gold ahead of him. So yeah, we're pretty happy about that. We're looking to invade the speed buff again, except with a Kukulkan this time. So this trade should feasibly go better for us. I went ahead and cursed all of them preemptively and ulted in. Forced Thor ult, Terra walls are down. That's a Kukulkan ult on the speed buff that hits the Odin. Pretty hard chunk there. Raijin did absolutely nothing the entire time. Thor ult came down and didn't do anything. Odin didn't ult because he got destroyed. And was there a Terra there? I didn't notice. Yeah, that was our invade. Worked pretty well. Tyr is over here. We poked Odin so hard that Tyr gets to try to invade the blue buff for free. Raijin jumps in on him, but that's okay because he's Tyr and he just runs away and he's fine. Thor is going for a gank on Coco. Let's check this out. He beads his Casper and probably is going to die here. Oh, wait. Misses the hammer. Or did he hammer away? I'm not sure. Either way, Coco lives, so I'm happy. However that happened. And he farms away, you greedy bastard. What are you doing? Go to base! Thor's here. Whatever. Grabbing some mid camps. We've amassed a 4k lead at this point. We're pretty happy about that. And honestly, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So we're just going to keep farming. If we can keep getting a lead, then we're just going to keep going. You know, why not? Looks like Ajax, cheeky little bugger, managed to steal away some red buff action with that hog of his. Actually, he didn't even hog it. And he still got it. That's dumb. Also really hilarious. I thought he'd hogged it in that game. The things you know when you watch a replay. Cool. Hi, Tara. How you doing? See, Tara, that's how you use a stun on Guanyu. Oh, that was a Raiju. That was a Raiju. Hey. Hey, Raijin, 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 Raijin. Right, yeah, no, look at me. Look at me, you fat dude. Look, fat dude, look at me. Look at, okay, fine, there's a team fight. When I say team fight, I mean Raijin walks around behind us. Thor and Raijin get completely destroyed by Colt-Colt-Connell. Jingwei dies for free, and Raijin's still sitting in the back line doing absolutely nothing. He turns around for some reason. He dies to archers. No, they all grouped up for Colt-Colt-Connell and Tornado, which was really nice of them, because we didn't set anything up for them. And we have a free Gold Fury. Thor's coming out of base, no ult. Odin picks up gold and hogs it. So rip the dream. But not too worried about it. Jingwei tries to 2-on-1 us. If we just trade body block aggro, he gets the rewind. And we force Jingwei out. And Cuckoo just heft her health with one ability. Because that's balanced. Zephyr does a lot of damage, dude. Zephyr does a lot of damage. We've got the Tier 1 Terran solo. We poke the one in duo. Gold's down, so it's kind of time to group and try to take a tower. They've actually come back 2k. Mostly due to that Gold Fury. But we do need to start grouping and taking advantage of this lead. Oh, well, we have it. So we're gonna farm buffs and try to push down mid. Tears looping around the back here, so we have a pretty decent fight that we can take. He has to be careful though, because he's getting 1v4'd at the moment, so I'm ulting through, trying to assist. Didn't really do anything except I got there really soon, and Cuckoo hits a free ult on the Thor, who didn't see it coming. He's also still level 11, so he doesn't have his active yet, which is why I'm trying to force this now. I've just completed Ghostwalk. We've got the Meditation on Tyr, which he used. And we're trying to siege a Tyr 2 for some reason. I don't know whose call that was. Probably wasn't a very good one, but whatever. Probably my call, to be honest, because I don't shut up. The one issue that I'm having right now with my build is I don't have an EMP5. Nor will I have an MP5. So I really can't sustain as hard as I would like. I'm really relying on Tears Med. But But I'm still Gwan, so I still have that full mana pool of, 600 heal. I was maxed by now and cost 80. So, how many heals is that? Probably like 10 heals with the little MP5 I do have. I'll just say 10 to make it easy. At 185 per. Most of them I'm healing with passive, but whatever. So we're gonna say around 1,000 healing every single out of base. Check out the healing. I've got 5,000 at this point. Looking at graphs, it's been a pretty straight downswing. Yeah, I have 8 wards placed, so I would have backed about 4 times at this point. Well, 5 times, because I still have 2 in my inventory. So yeah, it's 5 times for 5,000 health. So. That was a really bad one. I popped my curse, so the Terra ult does nothing. I popped my ghost box, so that does nothing. Cuckoo misses ult, but that's okay. It did force them back into the wall, so they were damaged by us. Raichu's gonna get exploded. And healing done is at 6,000. And I'm not even done yet. We have a free Phoenix now. But it was all dead. Deicide, take the Phoenix. Thorold's coming in, that's fine. He hits 3, that's fine. Can't do any damage, doesn't know how to teleport to his hammer because he knows how to play that god. And I've got a dip because Guan Yu doesn't have any MP5. Kronos is free pushing towers the entire time, which is great for him because he did go Wingblade, so he does need a little more farm to get that power online. My friend the Terra here doesn't have any magical protection at 20 minutes into the game. With a level 19 Kronos and a level 17 Cuckoo, who are doing a lot of damage. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy.
I say this from a support to a support. You either need Pestilence or you need Heartward. Right now.
Oh, by the way, we're cuckoo ulting the Gold Fury and stealing it from them because they don't know how to secure an objective. So that's really nice. Coco is carrying us like usual. And life is good. I picked up Mail Renewal because why not? I need more mana. And we're killing people, so I figured, hey. But you know, it's a great item from ahead, horrible item from behind. Pick it up and use it. I've got lots of health in this build. The Jingwei has Chinsai, but their Jingwei has zero pen. I'm an ADC player in my spare time, thank you. You need pen. I have sovereignty. You need pen. Tyr has 2 physical defense items. You need pen. Cuckoo has Dynasty Plate Helm. You need pen. Because you're not going to get through the Sov with the Chinsai procs, so I don't care about your Chinsai procs until you buy pen. Okay, penetration rant over. But the really important thing on here is the 3,000 damage Thor has done at 21 minutes into the game. Thor did not properly shut down the Kolku Khan. You're Thor. Kolku Khan should die multiple times. He's died how many times? None. Let me say that again. Kokkan has died 0 times. I pop my curse here, see how he would respond. He responded with Thorol running away. Probably the worst curse in A. Honestly, it didn't really do anything. But neither did Thorol, so, you know. We're ahead enough where I can use a relic to force an ult and not have to pay the price. Kronos has finished Obshard, so he's hitting a power spike as well. Honestly, this game was already over the minute we deicided them and got middle tanks. We are missing abilities left and right, but we're so far ahead that it literally doesn't matter. Odin's using his hog to stop Kronos damage, so that's nice. We're grouping up nicely for the bird bomb, but thankfully he misses. And we see no reason to not just go ahead and force down all these phoenixes back by an end. Coco really wants to end right now. He really does. And I'm like, gosh dang it, Coco, I gotta help you out of this situation now. He's backing right in front of a Thor. Like, that's Thor Odin. Let me back in front of him. So, Odin ults him. He Aegis's the Terra damage. Rewinds. All their ults are down, except for Thorol. Is what we were calling. I guess we mistimed the Terra ult. And we're just gonna walk into five people. We're gonna 2v5. I guess. While our team is farming mid camps! It's Reginald. I'm healing him. Or trying to heal him, except he's running away from me, so I can't heal him. I curse everybody. Everybody knows that Coco is just trying to buff his player healing right there. So. We kill three of them. And we can just end. So, not a problem. We've got Cuckoo ult. This game's already over. And thank you very much. 11 wards placed. Just gonna throw that out there.
Let's see if I can. No, we're gonna have to wait for the other screen.
The biggest reason why we won this game so hard was that Thor did less than 4,000 damage. There you go.